Hello friends, I hope you're having a fine day wherever you are in the world. My name's Christiane, I'm from England, but this week I'm going to be showing you a little slice of Greece. So to paint a picture for you, it is the second week of September in the doomed year of history that is 2020. The pandemic is still going on, but not quite as bad as what it was. There's a bunch of rules and regulations in place now, which means slowly but surely the world is starting to open up and tourism and the economy can get going again. Now, there are a bunch of destinations in Europe and Greece specifically which we shouldn't be travelling to right now. For example, Santorini, Mykonos, Zante, Crete. You have to quarantine for 2 weeks if you travel there, but luckily I had a flight to Thessaloniki, a city in northern Greece that is part of the mainland. It only cost me £65 for my direct return flights from Gatwick. The flight went well, we just needed to wear a mask the whole time, but it was well managed. I did vlog it, but had issues with the footage, so sorry you never saw that. In Thessaloniki, I got picked up from the airport by Leah and George. Leah is my best mate, and George has been her online Greek tutor for the past year, who also kindly hosted us when we were in the city. Together, we walked around the city, ate omelets with feta inside, drank coffee, drank Aperol Spritz, drank wine, and just generally hung out in George's family home. But that's just the introduction to this trip. We may only have 1 week in Greece, but there are big adventures ahead. Leah and I have rented a car and will be setting off to explore the legs of Halkidiki. Over the next 5 days, we will be road tripping up and down the first and second legs. Unfortunately, we are not allowed on the third leg as we are women. I'm not even joking. Anyway, it's time to pack and time to get going onto the first leg.
Beach, which is just half an hour from where we've been staying. We're actually staying the night at Posidi tonight, but Sunny Beach is on the way and it seems like a really good place to stop for lunch.
Okay, we have arrived at Sunny Beach, paid a savage 15 euros for parking, but it does mean that we can like just stay here all day. And I think that the resort here is quite bougie. We're just gonna bring our beach bag for the day with our mask and snorkel and things like this, have a nice lunch and a swim. It's so hot today. That car was absolutely boiling, even with the aircon and full blast. I was like, oh. But we safely got here, me driving on the right-hand side of the road. It's not my completely first time, if any of you remember me driving on the right-hand side of the road in Croatia.
Where's your clutch? Which one's which? That's still the clutch, that's my accelerator and that's my brake. So those haven't switched around from a left-hand sided car?
No, it's obviously.
Okay.
I was driving very slowly, like a snail, but like it's funny how kind of quickly you get used to it. Like the first 5 minutes is really, it just feels unnatural and you keep banging your hand up against the side because it's the wrong hand side for like the gear stick. And like, I don't know, my feet just kind of are like, what's supposed to be going where? But after like 5 minutes, you do get used to it and it's fine. And we've got here safely and happy days.
Oh, it's really good.
Yeah?
Yeah, I like that a lot. Do you want some? Can I try some?
I'll try one bit.
It's nice, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
That's tasty, that is.
That's really nice.
Really nice.
Good choice.
I've just been teaching Leah about spitting in your mask and why that's important and why we're gonna now rinse it and then put it on. She's like, why would I do that? And I was like, just trust me, just trust me. I've got the flippers. The water is so clear. It's not very deep, so we're gonna try and walk out a bit to try and get a bit deeper and we'll go for a bit of a swim.
Getting the slippers off. Well done, well done. She did it, she did it.
But it's too smart.
sand on them.
Yeah, it's difficult.
Yeah, it is.
We don't want to leave here, to be honest, but we can't afford to stay here for the night, so we're going to drive half an hour to our cheap accommodation.
Come on then. Time to go home.
Time to go home.
No one's left on Sunny Beach anymore, are they?
No.
No.
Not a soul.
How much wine have you had?
Yeah, 4 glasses of wine, so I thought I'd pose with a palm tree. Did you notice that as we moved away from the cheaper beach, the more expensive beach, they cleared up like the little bits and bobs that you see before you walk in? So like the bits of just sea shit from the sea.
Oh, really?
It was all clear on the posh
bit.
Oh,
really?
And I was like, they actually removed that.
That's so interesting. You see, I don't even think they make as much money on the posh one because there's not even a fraction of the amount of people there paying the price.
They just make the money from their hotel sales. We have parked in like the premium car parking people stay, but we just went to the cheaper beach. We had a great day.
Yeah, we had a fantastic
the best day ever. I got chatted up.
Yeah, you did.
Hashtag desirable. No. Let's not get our self-worth that way.
He might be watching the vlog, Lee.
Yeah, he might be watching. He just replied to an Instagram story with love heart eyes.
What's his name?
His name's Jamie. I'm taken, by the way. I just thought it was... You know what? You know you've been in a relationship for years, a few years, but someone shows an interest and you're like... Oh my gosh.
I'm attractive.
Young and attractive.
You think I'm attractive.
It was just funny. I haven't had that, so I just found it entertaining.
Anyway. I loved it.
It was Chrissy was there like, yeah. And I was like, I'm
the best sunset. Okay. So we just arrived in Puss City from Sunny Beach, and our lovely host of the apartments that we have booked has not taken us to our room, but is taking us to some sunset spot, which he is adamant that we see right now.
You have to go there in the morning to take a picture because the sun is from here.
Okay. Oh, it looks beautiful though.
This is amazing!
Yeah, this is sick!
Even in the full of season, you can swim here naked. Nobody knows this place, believe me.
Δεν
έχει, είναι λίες, δεν ξέρω πώς λέγεται η λέξη στα αγγλικά, είναι flat, no problems.
Όχι, no rocks.
Flat rocks. Between and sun, sandy and the rocks and sandy outside. And if you have a mask, you can see fishes, octopus, snorkeling, fishing, everything.
Amazing. Oh, we've got our snorkels.
I
love the little tour that we're getting before we check in. This is beautiful.
Next time you will stay only here for not one day or two. Because here it's easy to go everywhere in the first finger. Everywhere.
Yeah, yeah.
In 15 minutes you are everywhere. This is the peninsula.
So we've both just showered finally in our room. It's dark outside now. How nice is Christos? So Christos owns, these are called the Villas Panoramic Studios in Puss City. And as soon as we arrived, like Christos was just so keen to just show us around Puss City, even though the sun was literally had already gone down. He just was so passionate about where he's from and about this area and just wanted to show us around, which was so cool and so lovely. And like, you don't really get that anywhere else other than Greece. I feel like it's such a unique thing to hear, and the people here are just so friendly. And this place was so sorry, Leah's just changing in the background of the video.
Oh, it's all right. Can I be seen?
No, I don't think we saw anything naughty. If we did, I'll just censor it. This place was only 35 euros a night. And to think that we were considering absolutely splashing out and staying in Sunny Beach for the night, which would have been hundreds.
Never. Well, we considered it.
We were like, oh, do we do it? But we would never get Christos showing us around the town in like somewhere like that. Exactly. And for 35 euros a night, like, it's pretty decent. Like, we've got a nice double bed. We have a view. Obviously, it's dark, but I'll show you in the morning. We've absolutely emptied out our stuff here. We have a kitchenette, which we considered cooking, but we're actually going to go out for food because obviously. And then a nice little ensuite. Yeah. Like, it's perfect. It's all we need. And we're going to go out for some food now. It's late. It's like 9:30, but it's how the Greeks do it, apparently.
Thank you.
Greek. We are just leaving our accommodation in Posidi, but we haven't actually explored it yet. We actually spent the morning in a bakery just like doing some backup of our footage. It was really, really nice actually, and it was hilarious because Leah had some GoPro footage with her nipples out.
Accidentally
yesterday, and she was like trying to data transfer but make sure that no one else could see her laptop, so that was quite funny.
Also, can we just say, mate, that the nipple footage was non-intentional?
It was non-intentional. Yeah, she did not mean to do it. So we're now, first up is going to be like the nose of Posidi, called Posidi Cape. It's going to be like a 15 minute walk to the actual nose of it, and then we're just going to explore a little bit around Posidi before making our way out of the town and exploring the rest of the first leg before we leave it.
It's literally like a desert out here, but of course we've picked the absolute peak hottest time of the day to do the walk.
Yeah!
To do the walk where there's going to be no water, no food, oh, no nothing, cool. Just us and the desert. But the water will be there so we can go for a dip.
I think we should 100% take the brolly. It's so lightweight.
You reckon?
We can have shade, yeah, it's gonna be great.
Okay, it's gonna be great.
We've come here at like one. We're a joke.
It's a joke,
We're
isn't it?
A joke. Don't know what's more of a joke, us coming here at one or me putting makeup on.
Why? Is it sweating?
It's swishy.
Is it melting off your face?
It's swishy. I wish we'd bought a picnic so we could eat down there.
That would have been smart, but.
Yeah, but we're not that smart.
We are not that smart.
We're not.
We just don't think, we just want to be spontaneous, you know?
Yeah, spontaneous.
At least hopefully we won't get burnt. Oof. That would be one bonus of the day.
Are we just going to walk out literally just like that?
Yeah, 15 minute walk to the very edge of this, what's it called, peninsula.
Yeah.
We're going to walk underneath this brolly, which we're then going to attach to this. And we're just going to be like,
we're going to look
two ladies.
But we have made it to like the end of the cape, so we came from up there and then we've got here and then we've got the end just there. It's so beautiful. It really, really is very windy. We're trying to stay sheltered underneath our parasol. Finishing up at Posidi Beach. It was very, very nice. The
what
water.
A lovely time.
Lovely time. Water was lovely in the end. And we're going to press on. Now, the original plan was to go to Pefkachori Beach. I'm probably saying it so wrong, but that's how I read it, which is on the right-hand side of the first leg. But we were faffing about a bit too much this morning. And so we're going to skip that and we're going to go to Aphitos, which was a recommendation from George. Just supposed to be a really nice little village. Mm. So we're just going to head there. Leah's really hungry, but I've said, can you hold off half an hour? And she goes, yeah, I reckon so, just about. Yeah. So I've said, okay, well, we'll drive straight there. It'll take half an hour. We're going to eat as soon as we get there.
Yeah.
And explore the nice little village that is Aphitos. So we have arrived in the little town, the little village of Aphitos. And first thing that we need to do is find some food. I really feel like having something just like nice and traditionally Greek.
Okay.
Like just something like light and Greek.
Light and Greek don't go hand in hand. But yeah, we can. Get nice big salads and chicken.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yeah, that's what I want. I think we have found the spot where we want to eat. This looks really, really lovely.
That is lit. This view is lit because
It's the first time we're on the edge of a leg where you could see the other leg.
So those mountains that we see over there, that is the second leg, and that is where we will be in the next vlog. So stay tuned. It looks really good. Moussaka.
So nice.
I've gone for a vegetables tagliatelle. It's actually huge. It looks really good, and that's a really curious piece of equipment to eat it with.
I think you serve it yourself with it.
Oh, I'll put it on there. Yeah. Oh, that makes sense.
Or you just eat it all off there.
Yeah, true.
You know, for just a little bit of food and a runder around, and I've come away with a caftan, some trousers, and not one but two dream catchers, one for my car and one for my bedroom. I don't know how I plan on fitting this in my backpack, but that's okay, we will deal with the logistics later. I'm happy with my purchases. 56 euros, that was.
No way. This is not like you.
No, this is really unlike. I never just like stop in like boutiques or souvenir shops and get things. Like, it's really unlike me. But here we are. Two lots of purchases.
Yeah. Absolutely fantastic. You never do this.
I never do this, but here we are. I've done it.
Gonna have to squeeze it in my bag, mate.
I guess I'm just in a shopping mood, you know? And like when I'm never in Greece. And Greece is lovely.
What's the word someone said to you on Instagram for fancy backpacking? Was it
flashpacking?
Flashpacking.
Yeah.
So that's what you're doing now. Flashpacking.
I guess so.
You're a flashpacker.
I'm being a flashpacker. Yeah. The cheapest accommodation in Nikiti Beach.
So funny.
That's the kind of people we are. It took us a little bit of time to find it because it was unclear instructions on Google Maps. But no worries. I just drived around and just tried, hoped for the best. And we're here. We've made it. Mavrida's room.
Oh, God. The cheapest place. I can't wait.
Can't wait.
Do you remember those YouTube trends where it's like, oh, I stayed in the worst rated hotel in my city?
Doing that, but in Greece?
But actually, even though this was the cheapest on booking.com, the ratings were actually 9.1 superb.
Okay, so we stayed at the best rated hotel in Nikiti.
Yeah. And we've made it into the cheapest room in Nikiti Beach. It's very pink. He was like, do you want the pink room or the green room? And we were like, well, obviously the pink room.
The rose.
Actually, we've got a little kitchen there, we've got an ensuite. It's very similar to our other room actually, but actually a bit nicer. I'm going to end the vlog here. I really hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. In the next video, we will be exploring the second leg of Halkidiki. Make sure that you subscribe if you haven't already, and subscribe to Leah's channel for even more Greek fun.
Or just picked a spot. Sorry.
Just the life and soul of the party. And I will leave you on this vlog with a little fashion show of the things that we have purchased today. Bye!